A parish student hospitalized after being bullied inside a school cafeteria. Well, that's what his parents are claiming, and they want the school to do more to curb the violence. But as Tanya Dahl reports, school officials are responding with what is being done to keep kids safe.
It's tough being a kid. And this fourth grader says on Tuesday he was bullied by another student during lunch.
We got up and we went to go hit the athlete, and that's when the kid jumped in there and hit.
To protect the 11-year-old, we aren't identifying him or his mom, who was called in by school officials to come get her boy.
I was being called from a much out of school. I didn't know that he had been attacked, and he was having symptoms of blurred vision and dizziness.
The Jefferson Parish Sheriff's Office confirms that that confrontation between both students happened inside the school cafeteria, and now is investigating a complaint that's been filed. This concerned mom says her son was diagnosed with a concussion. She says he's been bullied at Mildred Harris Elementary School for 6 to 8 months now, and she'd met with school officials in the past to complain. This latest incident forced her to post her concerns on Facebook.
This time it really went too far. You know, when I got to school and saw the way my son looked, and then when we got the diagnosis, there still really drew a line.
The administration of the school took swift and appropriate action according to the school board policies and procedures.
But the Jefferson Parish Public School System is firing back, saying the student who threw the punch was disciplined, and that all of its schools follow a zero-tolerance bullying policy, including this Bridge City campus.
We have policies and procedures in place to protect all of our students, every school, every day.
Policies and procedures that this West Bank mom says need to be improved to discourage bullies from doing what they do best, instill fear.
Helping the kid with maybe ways to cope with bullying, and also help bullies know that what they're doing to the kids is damaging them.
Tanya Dahl, Eyewitness News.
We could.